I think maybe I'll go downstairs a bit because it is a bit laggy, isn't it? I'm on my way downstairs because of how laggy it can be.
I was just about to say that it's quite laggy.
Yeah, mic. It's laggy.
It was quite laggy. What?
Can you send me the link?
I've sent you the link.
To my email?
To your WhatsApp?
Oh, my phone's out of batteries.
Mate. I'll send it now.
Mate.
Always send it to my email.
Mate. Quite David O'Doherty today. Now look, I have to be in bed in 1 hour and 3 minutes.
Benazir Bhutto.
Okay.
Key to play.
Benazir Bhutto. No more people for with who.
You started with four. For whom, maybe.
No more people for whom it can be said. Benazir Bhutto. No more people for whom it can be said that their Christian name starts off and it's a normal name and you think...
Ben.
I've got to handle Ben, and then it goes mental.
Do we want him to name another?
Yeah, we do.
Could you name another?
Now you're asking.
Oh, are you saying the surname could be included in the name?
No, it's a Christian name, actually.
Oh, right. I mean, can we help?
No, I don't think so. Am I out?
Horne's got to be in bed in 58 minutes.
He doesn't want to go to bed when we're still on Cats 1.
Could you have something, I don't know if this will work, something like Dog Tanyan, but then Dog's not a normal name.
Edwina Curry.
Ah.
Edwina. That's the level of mentalness.
That's your level. That's your baseline.
Well, that does rule out quite a few people.
It changes direction from the expected.
So you're expecting Edward... I mean, because Edwina is the female.
Of course you're expecting Edward.
But you know she's a woman.
Can you say to someone, what's your name? And they say, well, it's Ed.
We'll do a woman's voice.
Well, ask me what my name is.
What's your name?
What's your name?
Ed!
Well, I don't think it's stopping there.
Edwina Curry at your service!
Oh, yeah, fair
enough. All right, well, I guess we carry on.
I'll tell you what. I don't love that as a response to my first category. I guess we carry on.
Catherine Ryan, no more Commonwealth. That's no more people born in a Commonwealth country.
Do you know what you've done there?
Is our country a Commonwealth country?
Is it?
Good point. Well, it is, isn't it?
Is America?
Ah, well, are we going to go through who all the Commonwealth countries are?
Yeah, don't tell him. Don't tell him.
Sadio... Oh, maybe his name's gone crazy.
No, but it doesn't start normal.
Mane. Oh, I have no idea what Commonwealth countries are.
Well, this is part of the point, isn't it?
Because he's born in Senegal.
And because it's a French colony, isn't it?
Why are you helping him?
The Commonwealth Games. That's how you remember it.
Yeah, you remember it from the Commonwealth Games.
Okay. Why, when he says...
Who are you pointing at?
You.
Who's you?
You.
I'm not in the same room as you.
Alex Horne.
Carry on. I'll do the pointing if you want.
Okay. Why are you helping him?
Who?
No, then you put your finger in. Why are you helping him?
I'm not helping him.
Whose go is it?
My go. No more people for whom it can be said that their surname is any part of a lion.
So, like Maine in this case?
Yeah. It's spelt Maine, isn't it?
Name another?
Paul Foot.
Ah.
Can I ask a question, Horne?
When?
Don't remember. Does the whole name have to be a part of a lion?
Yes, spelled correctly.
Okay, I've heard what you've had to say, and I've enjoyed it. But now I'm going to mix things up a bit.
you want us to respond? Do we look scared?
I almost said Willy Wonka.
That would be all right, wouldn't it?
It's the classic part of a line, isn't it?
The Wonka.
Oh, the Willy.
The surname.
Yeah.
Oh, in that case, Willy Wonka.
Ah.
I'm going to go Greg LeMond.
Cyclist.
A cyclist, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Ah, an alcoholic cyclist. And then do your bear impression.
Yeah.
And then do the impression of that bloke, Mr. Chips, who looks over the wall.
Is he called Mr. Chips?
Well, that, isn't it? That's it.
So, Greg LeMond. No more people for whom it can be said. Hang on. Are sportsmen or sportswomen.
Yeah, yeah. Great sentence. Great sentence.
Happy birthday.
Thanks, okay. Mate. I've got to be in bed in 48 minutes because it's my birthday.
How are we doing? Are you enjoying the game?
Either of you two guys ever done drugs?
Oh, now you're talking.
Weed, coke,
yeah.
Speed,
horse.
Amphetamines.
Ice.
Gas?
Okay. Yep, laughing gas.
Needles?
Yeah, you can put them in. You can put the drugs into your body with the needles.
The bells, knitting needles. We can. No, I've not done any. Yeah.
Maybe we should do a special where we're all on drugs.
Yeah, I mean, it is what it is.
Yeah, let me roll.
Can you pull your collar a bit further away so you've got more flesh? That's better. Yeah.
Yeah. That's it. All right. I can't remember what you said. What you just said. Okay.
Well, he was suggesting we should do a game on drugs.
Oh yeah, but I can't remember what his last category was.
Right.
Norman Mailer.
Sorry, I was just opening one of my birthday presents.
Oh, no, it's your birthday, isn't it?
Carry on.
Norman Mailer.
Sorry, I'm going to stop. I've got some letters.
Oh, okay, yeah.
You don't open your bank. That's from your bank. You don't open
I've got some receipts to look at. No more twinnies. In other words, no more people with the same letters in the names.
No more people with the same letters in the names.
Yeah, so in this case, 6 for Norman and 6 for Mailer. No more people with identically long first names and surnames.
I'm going to go with...
Oh, yeah, it skips a go, doesn't it? If someone does an American, it skips a go. So it's you again. Oh, I was nearly out then. Paul Simon. No more 2 first names.
Right, no more of those.
Penelope Pitstop.
Ha!
Penelope Pitstop. No more people for whom it has been said, I don't like it, I never have liked it, and I never will like it when I see Watson with that facial expression.
Oh, I don't mind it.
Yeah, I don't mind it if he's doing it when it's your go, but when it's like this... He's like a kestrel.
Hovering.
Ready to pounce.
Well, I would have heard swoop.
They hover and pounce.
A kestrel most certainly does not hover and pounce. A kestrel, you sad Mac and twat, hovers and then swoops.
I got sad and twat. Mackem, like from Sunderland.
Yeah, from Sunderland.
Maybe they do swoop.
You're in a world of trouble below the line.
Well, I've said maybe they do swoop.
Well, you might be okay then. Well, let's see. She's sort of like...
Well, I know what she wears in her hands.
Job gloves.
I wouldn't mind a job where I had to wear gloves.
All right, 90 seconds.
What's your 90-second business?
My 90-second business is your challenge, should you choose to accept it, is no more people who have been photographed wearing boots that come up to the knee.
Huh. higher than wellies, or would wellies count?
Okay, no more people who wear wellies or above.
In a photo that we can find in 90 seconds.
Listen, brother.
Just assume I'm listening.
Well, if you were listening, you'd be leaning into the screen.
Big you. Just lower your head.
Well, I finished my go.
Oh, have you? I mean, I'm tempted to challenge. Are you tempted to challenge Mark or not?
I've had a think, but I don't. I'd be supportive of you challenging, obviously.
Well, I will just for a bit of a laugh. Challenge. Well, I think we established her job in a previous game was she was a racer, and I think a racer is a sportswoman or man.
Oh no, absolutely not.
No,
I think it's a legit challenge.
Do you know what? It's not her job.
But we established it was.
Well, we didn't know what the fuck we were talking about. I noticed that someone below the line after that said that's not her job. She's a socialite.
Okay, well, who was the person?
Well, it's Hugh.
Hugh?
My friend Hugh. Yeah.
Oh, shout out to Hugh. There's a whole series called The Perils of Penelope Pitstop. All these people, like Muttley, do you honestly think Muttley's job is he's a sportsman? It's not Graham fucking Gooch. That is the easiest ever rebuttal of a challenge I've done in my life.
You've got to call it a rebuttal.
We've gone for a rebuttal.
I actually don't have to. And I've got that wrong a couple of times this week.
Firstly, I'm not arguing that Muttley is Graham Gooch. But if I agree with you on the major point that she's not a racer, then I'd have to concede that I was wrong in the previous game.
Do you know what? I don't want to dredge up other challenges, but there's... We're getting tantalisingly close to opening up the Donald Duck wound. I have a very simple question for you. Do you want to open up the Donald Duck wound or not?
No, the answer is no, because I need to be in bed in 33 and a half minutes.
33 minutes. So.
Well, then we proceed. And is it my go?
No, we proceed with the argument.
Okay.
So we're saying that Penelope Pitstop... We're saying that Penelope Pitstop...
By the way, if you cut that out,
okay.
Penelope Petspot. Yeah.
For this challenge to be incorrect, we're saying she's not a wacky racer.
We're saying she's not a sportsman or sportswoman.
We're saying that the racing is purely a hobby.
Yep.
And it's not a job at all.
The woman's bored.
We're saying they're watching amateur racers who can't be classified as sports people.
They're watching a trophy race.
I'm going to concede it's a wrong challenge purely on the basis that I also don't think Nigel Mansell is a sportsman.
Do you not?
No, not really. They're just a driver.
Right, okay, so...
All right, I'm down a challenge.
Yeah, it was a naff challenge and I battered it off with ease.
TikTok.
You know what? Yeah, all right, TikTok. But the people who watch this show...
Archimedes.
Here we go.
But the only trouble is... Just trying to remember the category, isn't it?
Have you remembered the Penelope Pitstop one yet?
No, but it can't be the same as Archimedes. Archimedes, no more people, you know, who, when you think of them, never held a mobile phone.
Challenge.
Oh.
Why not?
Are you walking, Mark?
I think I'll wait for the challenge.
You hear the name Archie. I don't think you're expecting it to go Medes.
No, but...
But I don't think it's his first name, and also you don't hear Archie.
Well, I think this category where someone's name goes mental is fraught with difficulties in a way.
It's not his first name.
I think this challenge sits down.
Do you want me to do the work? Is there any work to be done? My only reasoning for doing the work is that I thought I could sneak a glance at his actual first name and see if we're in luck there.
Oh, I don't think we start worrying about anything.
I think I'm going to unleash the beast. Well, Horn.
Yes.
I'm starting a clock. You've got 90 seconds to find Archimedes wearing some big old fucking boots.
You idiot. He's a Greek mathematician. I'm not looking at his first name because that will be a waste of time. I've typed in Archimedes in boots. Okay, there is somebody called Archimedes wearing boots. That's all I've got so far. Well, he wore sort of...
Now then! Wellies are above, Horn. Wellies are above.
No.
No.
No. And the game continues?
Yeah.
Yeah.
My go?
Oh, if you want, yeah, it skips one, doesn't it? If somebody does a Greek guy.
Yeah.
Was it wellies or up?
Wellies are above.
Mm. There's a guy who does a nice podcast. He's like, who's, oh, he's English.
Shame. That sounded promising, that one.
Mm. I mean, it's welly time. Bruce Springsteen. Can't imagine him in wellies. Fish? Does he wear galoshes?
I don't know. I've never seen him live, but I'm sure he doesn't sort of waddle onto the stage in long boots.
Yeah, but you're more likely to take a picture of him if he is wearing wellies. Because you'd go, bloody hell, that's Springsteen in wellies.
I saw him live, actually. At no point did he have, he didn't have great big boots on.
Okay. I'm just checking the, I'm just doing a little check of the other categories. Ready for the category?
Yeah.
No more dudes.
Challenge, mobile phone, Fyodor Dostoevsky, no more Russians.
You say he's never held a mobile phone?
Pardon me?
Have you not understood the game again?
Yeah, I've not understood the game again. I thought we couldn't have anyone who didn't have a mobile phone.
No, we can. It's the opposite. We can have anyone that has.
Well, what's happened there is that you've lost a category and no one else can challenge Springsteen because he moved on so quickly and said a name and a category. No, you're not out, are you?
Well, yeah, because...
Oh, because Dostoevsky's... Well, look, we have to... Watto and I have to have a little chat. I've been forgiven before for not understanding a category.
Yeah.
What I've done there is I've done a flourish, which I'm so confident about it that the... Anything good that comes out of that, I'm taking that. I've done something that stinks of feces.
I mean, weirdly, you have walked.
I'll tell you what, I'm not even going to be looking at stuff above the line. I'm not looking at the video. There's no two ways about it. I'm gone.
Well, that is something.
Watto to play.
All right, fine. Joe Pesci. I don't know. It's just the categories, isn't it? Remember what they are. But I think it's Joe Pesci. Is that how you pronounce it? How would you say it, Tim?
Pesci.
Pesci, I'd say.
It's a bit more of a sh before the k. Pesci. Pesci.
And you can do it in an American accent, Horn. Do you want to have a go?
Yeah. Joe Pesci.
Yeah, I might have a crack at that. Joe Pesci. What a?
Yeah. Joe Pesci.
I've never seen anyone read their bills like this. You're reading every word of it.
No more over 50s.
Well, I've got two potential challenges, but I've only got two potential challenges left in my life.
Yeah, in your life.
Hang on, I'm just going to get my phone because...
Yeah, don't waste some of the 90 seconds finding your phone.
I'm ready to do the work.
So I'm challenging. And I'm relying on... Key thumb to find a picture of Joe Pesci in wellies or above in 90 seconds.
This wellies thing is really difficult, I think. But I think it's really difficult.
But a lot of it is the skill in finding the picture. Because I'm sure it's wrong with it.
And I'm hoping, like, I'm a guy that really...
Oh, have you started the clock, Mark? I'll start it now, and we'll get up to 70. Is that fair?
Yeah.
I found, you know, boots and leather trousers, and I don't know where... I don't know where one starts and the other ends.
Well, find more. Leather's a good start, though. Look at motorbike boots, maybe.
Yeah, but or don't. Just don't find anything. It's interesting, isn't it? Like
Joe Pesci motorbike is great. I'm going to do that.
Well, yeah, but do it quickly.
Yeah, don't do it too quickly, I think, because, I mean, it's interesting, actually.
Why am I relying on him? It should be me finding it in 90 seconds.
Well, that's the thing, isn't it?
Bradley Cooper?
No, Joe Pesci, 20 seconds left. Why are you Googling...
I'm putting wellies.
No. Boots.
I'm putting fishing.
Please put your fishing boots.
Show it. I mean...
Okay, I'm almost there, Horn. I'm almost there.
How long to go, Horn? Time
work. One second.
You're right.
Okay, tell me if these are longer than a welly.
They're nowhere near... They're shoes.
That's how he fishes. He's made a film called Gone Fishing.
I mean,
yeah, right. So
I can't.
I would have thought he's wearing wellies at some point in that film.
If I spend my bedtime, which is in 6 minutes, Googling pictures of that and find quickly wellies on him, what were you Googling? You got Bradley Cooper.
One chance left.
Well, I'm not going to waste it on this one, but I will tell you at the end of the game what it was, and I'll be annoyed if it was, you know what I mean.
What did you do on your birthday?
I'm doing this.
I'll tell you what, I've never, whatever I've been doing on my birthday, said I'm doing this, sounding more pissed off than you just did.
What happens if it's a, if Horne has to go to bed? Is it just a draw?
No, I have to go to bed late. Do you know any of the cheeky girls' names?
No.
Yeah, I genuinely didn't see that behind you.
But of course, yeah.
It's these wellies. Everyone is wearing wellies. It's whether you can find the picture in 90 seconds. All right. I don't even know his name. Oh, yes, I do. And I can't have him.
It is difficult now.
I'm getting somewhere. Yeah, I'm getting somewhere. There's one category which is catching me out every time.
Oh, who cares?
Well, it's important to him because the game is...
Sorry.
You know when you can't think of really famous... No, it's not, no, as in I can think of the person, but I can't think of their name. But they're... Oh, yeah, here's his name. And again, can't have him.
Who was it?
No, it doesn't matter, actually.
Yeah, he doesn't want to give the category away.
Come on. Okay. No, come on, Evan.
Fiddly. Really fiddly.
I feel like I've got a reasonable grip on the categories for once.
Yeah, but I don't necessarily.
Come on. It's going to be Kristen Schaal. Kristen Schaal. Don't start Googling wellies yet, please.
Kristen Schaal, yeah.
Don't type it in yet. Okay, no more people with the same letter twice in a row in their name.
All right, challenge. We'll try the wellies.
We'll try the wellies.
On your mark, get set, welly time.
Tim, get me a picture of Christian in wellies or comparably high boots, please.
I've written Christian Schaal.
You've got fishing.
Ah, now then.
Ah, I don't like that noise.
I do.
But it's not her.
I like that noise.
It's just...
This girl wears shoes.
Not always.
No, she was in a film called This Girl Wears Shoes.
Is that her?
No. I don't like, is that her?
No, I don't think he's got anything.
I hope you can only see them from the legs down.
Well, here's the photo.
Their boots.
But is it Kristen?
Does it look like Kristen?
A lot.
I'm going to top up my wine. Because this is tense.
I'm visiting the site.
What I'm going to do in a minute, if it's Kristen, is spend 30 seconds Googling Joe Pesci in boots.
So I've returned to Ironhead Studio to design a suit for an enemy, an ultimate adversary, someone vile and evil, and the opposite of me in every single way. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Kristen Schaal.
I don't need to say any more.
Okay. First of all, thank you for agreeing to do this.
Oh my gosh, it's a dream come true.
Okay, second of all, I'm not sure.
They're just below the knee. Oh, yeah, you got
Can I have a little look for Joe Pesci in boots?
Yeah, have a look for Pesci, but that's a great challenge, Watto, you know.
You don't often see his feet, do you? I'm disappointed, but I don't think I've got any complaints.
I mean, I was getting Pesci muddled up with Dan DeVito.
I've gone for Joe Pesci riding a horse.
And you got him?
Nah. You found it in the last seconds.
It was very, very tight, actually. Actually, Keith, I thought you weren't going to bring that in for me. And, you know.
It looked unlikely, didn't it? I thought I was going to have it. My challenge was going to be, the other one was, I thought Joe might be short for something spectacular in Italian.
And what was it short for? Joseph?
Joseph.
Good category?
No.
Very difficult. And it's his birthday, actually.
I'm only 7 minutes late for bed. Watto, well played.
Oh, yeah.